so much of the work, especially the voiceover stuff and the on-camera stuff, you do in a vacuum. You know, you don't really get a sense. I mean, you hope someone's watching, but then you come to something like this and you realize, oh, it actually does get out there. People do see it and people appreciate it. So it's the equivalent of applause.
Futurama. It's been, it's gone, it's come back, it's gone out the other side. Can you talk a little bit about what, for you, the enduring magic of the show is and why it has proved so unkillable?
Honestly, I mean, I think, one, it's just the genius of the writing. You know, Matt Groening and David X. Cohen and their writing staff are literally geniuses. I mean, they're guys with PhDs and master's degrees in things that you can't even spell. But then there's also the fact that it's a cartoon which has real dedicated fans, and science fiction, which also has real dedicated fans. So it's this nexus of fandom. And I think that's part of what people are so deeply, you know, invested in the show. And that's what's made it come back several times from the dead. Well, I don't pay any attention to any of the characters other than mine. No. No, there are quite a few. I'm partial to the Fry-Leela romance episodes. Those always break my heart. I mean, most people are, you know, of course, you know, Jurassic Bark, the dog episode. That doesn't get me as much as the Holofoner episode where he just, like, he comes so close and then it goes away. But that said, there's also, you know, my Hermes episodes that I really love. You know, when I got to, you know, do a musical number and with how Hermes requisitioned his groove back. And I love the Lethal Inspection from our last season, where you find that Hermes and Bender share a past, you know. So, I don't know. On a show that good, it's hard to have just one favorite.
Of course, Hermes is a character that fans absolutely adore. Why do you think such a pointless bureaucrat has become so beloved by so many people?
Well, I think it's the combination of the bureaucracy and the marijuana. You know, it's got something for everyone. Everybody, get in line and come get this, you know.
Of course, Hermes is well known and beloved for his expressions, his sweet outfits. Do you have a particular favorite of the ones that fans seem to request the most when they're getting you to do your Hermes impressions for them?
Well, oddly enough, I always thought it would be one of the, you know, sweet gorilla of Manila. But the thing most people request is actually my manwich, which I didn't even know was a thing until I started coming to conventions. I'm still struggling to try and find an animal name that rhymes with London. It's very difficult.
The Futurama cast lend their voice to lots of little side characters. Is there a particular character or a soundbite that you've contributed to the show that people might not immediately recognize as you, but you're especially proud of or wish people knew?
Ooh, that's an interesting question. There's a secondary character called the Robot Preacher that I did, and that's been, especially in the Proposition Infinity episode, where he tries to deprogram the robosexuals. There's not really a catchphrase in that one, but it was a fun episode. Well, at these events, you know, the Justice League comes up a lot because, you know, there tend to be a lot of superhero stuff, and these days even more than ever. And also, I would say Samurai Jack, the Cartoon Network show that we actually, you know, got to come back to again this year for the first time in 14 years. I'd say those are the things that people bring up the most often. I was just excited to be able to come back to the character because it's a fantastic show. I mean, it's literally a work of art. And what Gendy and the other guys did with this new season, I think, transcended even the work that we'd done in the original four seasons. I'm incredibly proud to be a part of it. There's a new show called Get Shorty. With Ray Romano and Chris O'Dowd that I'll be doing in this. I'm not sure when it's coming out here. As well as The Jellies, a new animated show for Adult Swim. And I've got my own animated project with a few of my Futurama mates coming up in this fall. So I'm very excited about that.
In terms of Futurama, will the show ever end? Because I think fans are hoping it doesn't.
You know, the answer to that question is far above my pay grade. I will just simply wait for them to give me a call. Honestly, the only thing I have to say to the fans is, you know, thanks for watching. Because if no one was watching, it'd be like dancing alone in your bedroom, you know, so...